purpose is how I can raise up ordinary men, turning them to become supernatural beings, financial apostles, making life better, bringing people from the dungeon of sin, bringing them into the faith, planting their feet, and rising them.
What he knows! What he knows!
Can you just lift up your hands and thank you? We thank you. We thank you. Oh, come, let us adore. Oh, come, let us adore. So thank you. Only Shabada Badaba Sapodia. We thank you. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you, Lord. I am that I am. omnipotent, omniscient, we thank you. We thank you, Lord. We thank you. We thank you. Just thank him. Thank him. We can only pay by our collision thorn. That is why we sing Baba O Eshe. That is why we sing Baba O Eshe. Our Father, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. Daddy has said, may I be decreased and may you increase. Daddy, may I be decreased and may you increase. Lord, we promise to give you all the glory in advance. All the glory. That no man will share the glory. That no man will take the glory. Father, all the glory. We thank you. We thank you. Give you all the praise. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. You can be seated. Hallelujah. Are you blessed? Can I hear you shout a bigger amen? Hallelujah. I thought you are shouting the amen well. I have two scriptures to knit, and then from there we move together. You don't mind, you can sit and we read the scripture so that those who are stretching their neck to see me can see me. Hallelujah. Obadiah 1:17. Obadiah chapter 1 verse 17. Are we there? Obadiah chapter 1 verse 17, immediately after Amos. It has just one chapter. Immediately after Amos and before Jonah. Are we there? But upon Mount Zion there shall be deliverance, and there shall be holiness, and the house of Jacob shall possess their possession. Let's read it all together. One, two, go. But upon Mount Zion there shall be deliverance, and there shall be holiness, and the house of Jacob shall possess their possession. Genesis chapter 4 verse 14 to 16. Then we have a seat. Genesis chapter 4 verse 14 to 16. Are we there? Surely you have driven me out this day from the face of the ground. I shall be hidden from your face. I shall be a fugitive and a vagabond. And the earth, and it will happen that anyone that find me will kill me. And the Lord said to him, that's to Cain, therefore, whosoever kills Cain, vengeance shall be taken on him sevenfold. And the Lord set a mark upon Cain, lest anyone finding him should kill him. And the Lord set a mark upon Cain, lest anyone find him should kill him. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. Can I hear you shout a bigger amen? I want to share with us on what I titled, Breaking Generational Altar of Curse. 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 There's hardly no home in Africa that is directly or indirectly not connected to one altar or the other. Whether you admit it or you don't admit it, it doesn't change. It is a truth. Either consciously or unconsciously, either you are the starting point of it or your great-grandfather did something that you did not know about, and that is defining your destiny. Breaking generational altar of curse. Breaking generational altar of curse. I'm not here to make noise. I'm here to make news. I'm not here to make you happy, but I'm here to make you happen. I say you will begin to happen. You become the happening thing in town. I say you become the happening thing in town. I didn't hear that amen like thunder. Sit down. A curse have the ability to travel for 430 years without obstruction. A curse have the ability to travel for 430 years without obstruction. In Exodus, we heard God said in his word, I am the God that visits the iniquity of the father upon the children from the first generation to the second generation to the third generation, even to the fourth generation. So the lifespan of a curse can be 400 years. You get what I'm saying now? That means if a generation is 100 years, a curse can travel for 400 years. That means that no matter the antivirus medicinal application you use on a curse, if you don't use the proper therapy, the proper hammer of the word of God, the curse will still be traveling like a virus of HIV in your bloodstream. A curse will travel and it will render you useless. 95% of why you are the way you are is a generational curse. And the greatest problem that the enemy has done to the African generation is to make us feel comfortable while we are cursed. The fact that you eat and you drink and drive a car does not make you better. The question is, where were you supposed to be 10 years ago, 5 years ago, 15 years ago? Are you where you ought to be? And if you are not where you ought to be, it simply means a curse is fighting you. And today I came to break the curse. I didn't hear the amen well. When you are under a curse, you walk like elephant and reap like ant. When you are under a curse, you can be beautiful, but yet you are frustrated. When you are under a curse, men will come and go. When you are under a curse, you might stay for 10 years trying to labor, and there is nothing to show for it. When you are under a curse, there is a particular sickness that flows. Maybe asthma, maybe diabetes. Your great-grandfather has it. Your father has it, and you have it. When you are under a curse, maybe there is something called hypertension. Your great-grandfather has it. Your mother has it. And now you have it. And you say, my asthma, my diabetes, my hypertension, it is not your property. You are about to divorce that thing. Sit down. Am I helping somebody here? So now hear this. A curse is an unpleasant word spoken to the atmosphere to enforce unpleasant manifestation. A curse is an unpleasant word spoken to the atmosphere to enforce a negative manifestation in your life. So there are certain curses that comes as
as a result of declaration. There are certain curses that come as a result of covenant. There are certain curses that come as a result of manipulation of the enemy. Why are you the way you are? Why are you where you are? Why is it that you have not gotten better? God sent me here as a liberation agent to bring an end to that curse. Now hear this. You can be educated and your certificate is a tissue paper. I have masters, I have PhD. Useless when curse is in operation. I have seen masters hold a driving car. When you are under a curse, forget about having contacts everywhere. You will keep get. You are always having business appointment at the end of the month. What is to show? Nothing. You are so beautiful. You perfume yourself. You catwalk, gorilla walk, and dog walk. But yet, no woman, no man is coming. Can I talk here? When a man of God is under a curse, he will pastor a church for 10 years and be paddling 15 members and think it's normal. It's not normal. It's a curse. Can I say this? It is a curse to remain small. It is not a curse to start small, but it is a curse to remain small. If you are pastoring a church, first year, second year, third year, you are not growing, my brother, you are under a curse. Don't try to please yourself. You are under a curse. Brother Peter started a church with 3,000 members. The Bible says in Acts chapter 2, and the Lord added to the church 3,000 men, such that may be saved. It is an error to remain small. Sit down. When you are under a curse, whenever you see progress, you'll be against it. People who have that curse mentality have a myopic, pingomic, and microscopic mentality. Here it is, your abnormality and normality comes out of your mentality. And what lives in your mentality will affect your locality. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. When you have a productive thinking faculty, you become a faculty of wealth to your generation. A faculty of productivity, not activity. Activity is not productivity. You can be too active, busy doing nothing and producing nothing. Can I help you here? Can I help you here? Is somebody hearing what I'm saying? Curse will frustrate the work of your hands. You work, they frustrate it. You work, they frustrate it. You work, they frustrate it. But today marks the end. I didn't hear the amen well.
Am I helping somebody here?
A curse is an invisible barrier that keep people from God. That keep people from God, from their success, from their breakthrough, from their lifting. A curse is what puts together to cause great calamity. It's words put together to cause great calamity. Generational curses are judgments that are passed on individuals because of the sins that have been perpetrated in the family as a member of that generation. Generational curse is similar to sin, but it's different from sin. Sin brings eternal judgment, that means in the world to come. But generational curse brings bondage to you in this world here. You will suffer it here. Who can be under a curse?
A man of God can be under a curse. Numbers chapter 12, verse 9 to 10. We saw what happened to Miriam. We saw what happened.
A curse was placed. She became leprosized. A president or a country can be under a curse. There are certain countries that are under curse. Under curse. Malachi chapter 3, verse 9. He said, ye are cursed with a curse. Ye, this whole nation. So a whole nation can be under a curse. Each time I look at my country, Nigeria, I know nothing else but curse that have been brought by our fathers and what I call wicked kind of politicians. A single individual can be richer than a nation. Nigeria is a country rich with mineral resources. Second to none in Africa in oil. I think about the fifth largest oil producing country in the world. And yet, our oil can't go round. Citizens are struggling because of greedy politicians. And that's why I advocate for Christians to enter politics. We are not born to clamp our hand in the church. And we say, we bring the sacrifice of praise, we drop it. That's not what we are born to do. We are born to change the world. We are born to change the world. Am I helping you? We are not to clamp our hand. Is it clamping our hand? No. Church has gotten above the level of clamping our hands. We have to affect generation, affect people, affect our locality, affect our mayors, affect our councillors, affect our legislator, affect our parliament, affect our billionaires. We are not just bench warmers. See now, let me talk to you. When I hear believers criticize other believers for being rich, I say this is stupidity. Who is supposed to be wealthy? Unbelievers. Unbelievers. You see how the devil has cursed the church and made the church feel that prosperity is not gospel. Look, you cannot spread the gospel by prayer. If not, intercessors would have spread the gospel. Zechariah 1:17. My city through prosperity shall be spread abroad. Not through holiness, not through speaking in tongue, through prosperity. Through prosperity. Am I helping somebody here? I see some great generals rising up here. Sit down. I was in one of these countries, and the vice president sent for me. I think it was the day two or day three. I was preparing to go for the program and had 2 hours. And the vice president wanted to see me by all costs and sent for me. And I smiled. And I told the organizers, my son's there. I said, why should I go to him when I have to preach to souls? And they say, Papa, you don't understand. I said, there must be mental problem with you people. And I said, set the car, let me go to Crusade Ground. And I went to the Crusade Ground. I came back, I said, me, go to meet him. For what? Am I under a curse? Am I begging for money? You see, when you are blessed, you are not moved by people. But when you are poor, you run after people. Am I helping somebody here? Received nothing less than 4 invitations of presidents to come, and I've turned them down, not because I am proud, but because I understand that I carry the ark, and you go to look for ark. Ark doesn't go to look for you. And I could do that because I am prosperous. If I am not prosperous, I cannot do that. I curse property out of your life. Sit down. Am I helping you here? Shapakutu pariata. Zeporikoto ziparia. sit down. My personal PA have been here. There was a time I was so tired. Somebody from the government came to the church. She had to follow the normal protocol. She says, I think a senator or something like that. She had to follow the normal protocol to see me. She didn't want to. Then one of the people that came and said, Pierre, come. Hey, this woman has so amount of money now. She wants to give Papa now. And so if she give Papa, let Papa, Pierre laugh. I said, is it money? I've not told him what to say, but he knows what I will say. He knows what I will say. He said, in fact, because you have involved money, you are not seeing Papa. I'm trying to draw out something here. People believe that every pastor that comes to South Africa is coming to look for money. No! There are some that God have loaded. Am I talking to somebody here? Am I talking to somebody here? God punish poverty. Am I helping you here? Sit down. So a man can be under a curse. A president can be under a curse. A nation can be under a curse. A pastor can be under a curse. I have seen pastors. I remember one pastor, 45, bedwetting. Another one, 53, bedwetting. And these are great generals. So there is a curse. When I begin to trace it, I discover that was what happened to the father. That's what happened to the grandfather. And it's a normal thing. The wife had to leave the one that was 53 years. I mean, for 17 years, he kept bedwetting, not stopping. Because there was a curse fighting over his life. There's something wrong with the reason why your life is the way your life is. There's something wrong. It is not normal. What am I saying? It is not normal. You are intelligent. You are well-behaved lady. But yet, men don't stay in your life. And when men stay, they go. When friends come around your life, they look for a way to destroy you. There's something wrong. There is a generational curse that is attacking your life. Every firstborn in your family always die. Now you have delivered your firstborn. They are attacking your child and they want to kill your child. It's a generational curse. There is a curse. It is either from your husband's side or from your wife's side. Something is wrong somewhere. Listen to me. You might not be cursed directly, but if your husband is cursed and you join hand together, that curse will begin to cause a chemistry reaction. And that's why you must tell yourself, enough is enough. I'm going to put an end to that curse. I didn't hear the amen well. Sound the amen like thunder.